Welcome back, guys. So you can see the steering wheel turning around and there's nothing else happening. So
please welcome back. In this video we are fixing the JCB 532 load all teleporter, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, the steering wheel has stopped working. So somewhere down below there's splines, and obviously the splines have after ringing themselves, because I can just turn the steering wheel in both directions and just freewheel. So in this video we're going to fix the steering wheel on the JCB 532 load all, which is pretty much the same for nearly any load all or teleporter or JCB for that matter. So yeah, let's get back into it. Let's go.
Okay, so I went to turn the steering wheel and yeah, not really connected to anything.
Okay, so to remove the steering column, obviously I've already removed it. There's two 17s here, one here and one in there. And there's two more 17s all the way down there. You see there's one there and on the other side of that loom. You can see up there at the top of my finger, that's where the second one is. And there's a little tiny bar that goes across here to make it extra difficult. So my one, I couldn't get it out because this panel here had been welded, and also it was just very difficult to get out. So what we did was we drilled a series of little small holes here to find this bolt here, which is what the column pivots on. We removed the clips here and here. And with this one here, now the pin totally removed, and obviously the adjuster for locking it removed, it allowed the panel here now to pivot slightly sideways, and you can bend this bar back a little bit as well, which allowed it to pop out from this one here, because we weren't able to try that one back out. And then that came out, made it a lot easier. And then obviously at the bottom we still have to do that. There's two looms to undo as well. They were both undone, and the steering wheel, a little bit of effort, and the steering wheel comes out in one go. So that's now the steering wheel removed.
So guys, keep watching to the end of this video where you can see the exploded diagram of the steering column.
But check out the video of how I fixed it.
Okay, so just here we have the steering column and steering wheel out of the JCB, and yeah, here at the very bottom the splines rung off. So while I was feeding the animals, I was turning the steering wheel and suddenly it just freewheeled. So I have to feed the animals again today, so it looks like I have to have this fixed as well today. It looks like also the engagement was only, what's that, maybe 3 mil or 4 mil, and they give you quite a lot of room here, but obviously like when the shaft or the receiver, the plug or the female end that it joins into, it's quite shallow, so I use a screwdriver and I thought it was just full of rust or dirt or something. And no, it is actually nearly that shallow. So what I think of doing is either welding up this way or welding it all the way around and then cutting the splines back into it. You got any better ideas? Leave a comment in the comment section down below. And yes, obviously the proper way of fixing it is just to replace the entire shaft. I have animals to feed later on today, so I don't really have time to be sitting around waiting for this shaft that could take a week to arrive. If we can get this fixed today, we'll go with it. Okay, so just after using a wire wheel, so it's all lovely and shiny. On the good bit that hasn't been damaged, take a measurement, it's 20 mil. So what we're going to do is I think we either try and run a bead this way or run it around and see how well it welds up. I might actually just try and run it around, because then I can use the grinder and use it as a guide and try and cut the splines back into it. Like, it's ruined anyway, so no matter what I do, I can only make it better. Okay, so it may not be perfect, but it is welded the whole way around. And now what I'm going to do is cut some splines into it. Well, first of all, I'm going to center the shaft so it's a perfect circle all the way around, and then we'll cut the splines in afterwards. Okay, so I have the steering shaft locked in a big socket so I can turn the steering wheel, which is basically like a lathe that I can turn it. And slowly turning it, make it into a nice circle. So yeah, it's looking pretty good. Might be a little bit high just there, but I can shave that down. Now I'm going to use a caliper to make sure it's 20 mil, nearly perfect circumference. Okay, that's 20 mil the whole way around, so it's as close to a circle as I can make it. So yeah, now we're going to try and cut some splines. I haven't done this before, so let's give it a go and see how we get on. Can't make it any worse. I can always weld it up afterwards. Hey! Okay, first blind cut. Let's say cutting and see how we get on. Okay, so I've cut, I think they're called the flutes. So the basically the little channel between each line. So they've been cut all the way around. Next, I'm just going to angle just the cuts left and right, just to give it a little bit of taper. But it seems to be pretty good. Like, even if they're slightly off, as long as they're all matching the splines that they've been matched into, and obviously the one that it has matched into is a little bit worn as well, so there is a little bit of play. Otherwise, this wouldn't work. Okay, that's as good as it's gonna get. I have it pretty much all lined up. Not the best job in the world, I'm definitely not happy with it. But I have a load of hungry cows looking at me going, where's our food? I'm like, well, the loader's broken. So this is literally a get out of jail today card where I have to just make this do. So how would you do it properly? Well, I think you'd have to put it in a lathe, mill it perfectly circular, and then use a cutting knife to actually cut each of the splines into it. I don't have any of that equipment, so this is the way I'm doing it, because literally I need to have it done today. And what it's going into is also a bit worn, so I don't think it's going to matter too much, as long as there's something there just to grip it. But I think it's going to be okay. What do you guys think? Leave your comment in the comment section. Let's down. Install it and see how we get on. And let's see how correct my cutting ability is. Like, it is. They are all fairly straight the whole way around. Anyway, it's better than it was. So let's try that now and see how we get on. Okay, looks very empty now with the steering column removed. Okay, you can see down there, we have down there, that's what the female splines are. And yeah, there seems to be a lot of rust in it. I'm not sure whether that was the cause of it or why it suddenly just jumped out, but anyway, we're gonna fix it. Okay, so I have it all welded up. Now the steering column gets reinstalled back in there. Okay, it's going back in, finally. So we can feed these hungry moos. Moo. Okay, so what we're going to do first is take the shaft there and put it into that hole down there at the very bottom. When that's lined up, we'll line up the two 17s up here, and when they're lined up, obviously then you can just line up both of them. I've since put this bracket back in, and you see I've cut a piece here out of it, and there's a notch here and there's a notch further down. I welded up the notch to give it the strength back into it, but it just makes it a lot easier, because otherwise you're kind of going through a circle and you can't really see what you're doing, and there's so limited space. This is the easy way of doing it. So the correct way to do it is to remove everything just here in one big go. The plastic is held on by two nuts here and here, and there's two more nuts down here, one there and over there, but I cannot get them out. They are frozen with rust and time, so looks like this is not going to come out. So this is the way I'm doing it. Probably not the right way, maybe a little bit more difficult, but I cannot get any of these removed, so they're just going to stay put. And also the wiring and everything is with it, so I think it's better off just to leave it alone. And thankfully I've only had to remove two looms. So this one, you can see it down there, that's the joiner of it, and the other one for the wipers, which is further down there as well. Okay, so a slight change of plan. When you have the center shaft down into the socket down below that for the steering, and you know it's locked in because you can turn the steering wheel and you know you can feel the resistance, then line up both of these and lock them down, so basically the shaft can't move up and down. So that's locked in place for this one, and you put the spanner in underneath all of this on the opposite side and lock the other one in. Then when this in, you can go then down this way and in through there, and you can't even see it anymore, but there is two bolts down there to lock in. And once they're locked in, basically that's the steering wheel now locked in, and you can feel the resistance, so it is actually locked in. So delighted with that. Next thing is put in the loom. And very wisely by JCB, both the loom for the forward and for the wipers is the exact same. So it's possible to actually plug them in the wrong way around. So the way you know if you plug them in is if you put on the ignition. I only have one plugged in at the moment. If you turned on, say, like your wipers went backwards, if it starts beeping, as in the machine wants to go backwards and the warning is on,
it means you plugged it in the wrong way around. So this one here, yep, it's in the right one. And also the way the wiring is wired up, if you press this one, which is probably to squirt the windows, nothing happens. But if you press this one, it beeps the horn. So if it beeps the horn and reverses, you plugged in the right loom, because if you mix them up and you can hear it beeping to reverse, but you can't beep the horn, then you plugged in the wrong one. Obviously on everyone else's loadout, you won't have this whole big hole cut out of it. This hole was cut out to get this welded up, and I think there was a problem with the shuttle. So yeah, that's that now done. Okay, that's now everything back together again. I even have the lock for locking in the angle. So I would set it there. Okay, that's locked up. Now to turn on the key. Lovely and smooth, I can feel it gripping. And woo! Look at that! The wheels are turning! Right lads, time to get you some food. Okay, and we have the JCB all fixed. We've got to feed the animals. Nom 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 nom. Alright lads. It's good. Oh yes. Okay guys, so as you can see, yeah, we have a friction back in the steering wheel and it's holding steady. So thanks very much for watching. That's how you fix the JCB 532120, and it's the exact same for nearly any other JCB, or probably even other makes of loaders as well. So that's how you fix it. Bit of time, bit of effort, but I'm able to fix it and get the cattle fed today. So if you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe down below. Underneath this video you can scroll across and you see a donation. You can give me a donation if you like this video, because I couldn't find anyone else to fix this JCB, so it's a bit of a novice idea of how to fix it. So if you like it, give it a thumbs up, give me a donation. It always helps the channel and helps me make more videos. And as always guys, thanks for watching. See you later.